always whenever I go, I say that let us start everything with the oldest language in this universe, which I always say is Tamil. Though, actually, why I believe is language is the only way we can express. And we thank our ancestors for making such a lovely language. So, let us start with the Futai one. So, this is the second time I've been honored with, associating myself with the Taiwan Film Festival. But I should always say that, sir, Taiwan Sotrudha, Nama Ella Taiwan Sotrudha. Charles, our respected Charles, sir, I'm just telling about Taiwan in Tamil, which I'll again speak to you. I'll just brief you what I spoke. The issue is simple, sir. Taiwan Sotrudha. Taiwan, a good country, which underwent a lot of problems, and they were under the oppression of Japanese oppression, Chinese oppression, Lella Nadula, they emerged one of the biggest countries today. Once upon a time, goods were from Japan, goods were from China. But now today, only two countries are ruling the world. One is Taiwan and one is Korea. Taiwan, most of the goods, most of the inventions, most of the big companies, one of the biggest ports, technology, today Taiwan plays the most vital role in that. Good. As far as cinema, first they made films just with the influence of Chinese culture and Japanese culture. They had no independent culture, they had their own culture, but they were influenced by the Chinese and Japanese due to the invasion and and their freedom was suppressed. Afterwards, they broke free and they made films. When they made films, not ordinary films, they made wonderful films. They made very good films. In fact, they made a blockbuster called Cape 7, I think. Cape 7, right? Cape number 7 or something. It was one of the biggest blockbusters. Then they started making films now which were not only acceptable to their market, but to the entire Mandarin market also they started making. And their films started going across seas, they started going to other countries also. In fact, I should also tell you that we should be proud that a lot of film shootings have started taking place in Taiwan. In fact, Life of Pi, we have seen, it's a wonderful film. Do you believe that Life of Pi, most of the special effects were shot at Taiwan? Yes, Life of Pi, the whole sea sequence was shot in Taichung, I think so. Is it Taichung? At Taichung, they have got a wave pool. They done the whole blue mat, all the graphics was done at Taiwan. That is the technology development. So we should do a big hand. Life of Pi, I should proudly say that they came with open arms to the Indian film industry and they said, please come to Taiwan, join with us, collaborate with us, let us make joint co-productions. So they gave us an offer. And what did they do? I have to say, first of all, I was told, sir, you want to shoot for me, sir? Where Life of Pi was shot, Adi wave pool. We will give it free of cost. Only pay the consumables, the water charges and electricity charges. This is the letter which they gave. They gave an open invitation for Tamil film. That is say, we don't want any charge from the country. Please, that is say. They wanted to do this just because to build more trade ties with India. They wanted to develop the relationship between Taiwan film industry and Indian film industry. In fact, that is a great blessing. And we should be proud that most probably this may take place within another 3 or 4 months. An entire crew, Indian crew, I cannot mention the crew, is going there to do a அங்க போயிட்டு அந்த லொகேஷன்ஸ் பார்த்துட்டு அதே இடம் லைஃப் ஆஃப் பை ஷூட் பண்ண அந்த இடத்துல போய் படம் ஷூட் பண்ண போறாங்க. This is something I want to tell you. So simple, it is simple. No country will develop so big. It is because one thing is, one is புத்தி வேணும், அதுபோல் நல்ல மனசு வேணும். இங்கே இருக்கிற ஆளுகளுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் நல்ல மனசு, warm hearted people. The first thing they said, please come, please come, we are with you, we'll help you. Similarly, the warm hearted inner feeling is there in most of their villains. So what shall we do? Let us watch their films. Try to understand the films. I don't want to take much of your time. I'll make it much more. Get a mic, I speak. Not for that. I want to express my feelings. Yeah. Out of that. When we started speaking about films, yeah, out of the new emerging countries which make good films, Taiwan, Iranian, all these countries have started coming up. They make good films which have got human value. Okay, some films may depict, people say, may depict violence, etc. But they have made a difference, and these films, Taiwanese films, do create a big impact. So let us all watch these films, understand those films, you know, enjoy those films, and make this festival a great success. Once again, I thank the Taiwan, I thank especially Mr. Charles, you know, who has been always helpful in getting us these good films. Last but not the least, சென்னை ஃபிலிம் ஃபெஸ்டிவலுக்கு ஒரு தந்தை, ஒரு ஃபாதர், எல்லாருக்கும் ஒரு அப்பா அம்மா எல்லாமே நடக்காது. அந்த அப்பா சொல்றது இந்த தங்கராஜ். தங்கராஜ் would have not had the Chennai Film Festival. So, we should all thank him. This is another way. Why I have to say this this time, a little more serious. He came one day to my house and said, sir, why is I put you? I'm going to resign. I want to leave everything. Please, everyone ensure this character does not resign. He remains here. He is with us. Let him unitedly, let us also unitedly work with him. Make this Chennai Film Festival a big success. So please ask him to be with us, tell him not to resign and go, tell him to remain there till Chennai Film Festival is there or till he is there. Let us conduct unitedly, jointly, let us all work, make these film festivals big, let us all enjoy films. Thanks to the film industry, thanks to Dada Saab Phalke and to every person, especially I thanks Mr. Charles and his wife and the entire Taiwan community for coming forward and giving their films. And we will also plan to conduct a Tamil Film Festival at Taiwan. Let us do it. For that, the South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce is willing to come forward and cooperate and do anything, whatever they want. Once again, thank you. Please watch films. Thank you.
Mr. Ravi, Mr. Tangraj, please sign greeting. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It's my great honor and pleasure to be here to say a few words about our cooperation and efforts, especially from the first day of our arrival 2 years ago. We started promoting cultural collaboration between India and Taiwan, especially the film industry. As Mr. Ravi explained to all of you. Actually, I have written to your ambassador in Taiwan, Mr. Sridharan. So from the name you know, he is local Chennai people, Mr. Sridharan. And with a long list of the movies that we highly recommend to be promoted in Taiwan. And luckily enough, he wrote back to also highly recommend 2 films. So you are the first group of people to get the good news, because I just got it a couple of days ago before we received a dedication. So 2 very important movies is are going to be promoted with the collaboration of our Indo Cinema Appreciation Association. Very soon we are going to invite a delegation from them to visit Taiwan together with some of the producers, directors, to go to different places to locate suitable places for a new movie. So all the supporting assistance would be provided and offered by our different cities and counties authorities. So I would very much look forward to closer collaboration between India and Taiwan. We understand India manufactured 1,500 more movies a year. In Taiwan, maybe less than 50. But the topics and the process and the ideas may be very different. Mainly our producers and directors focus on people living in the countryside or in the major city, the problem that they face to be lonely living in a place very far away from their hometown, and the surroundings where they grew up have been overdeveloped, and their friends, their families all face different kind of problems that create distress to all of them. So how can the people find a way out in a modern society? That's the theme of this year's Taiwan Film Festival. It also coincides a series of our Taiwan Arts Week. Earlier last week, we have another delegation coming over to deliver a cultural performance. And this week, we continue the second leg of our Taiwan Art Week, featuring Taiwan Film Festival. I welcome every one of you, and thank you so much for joining us this evening. And don't miss any film in the coming 3 days. They all depict different issues, but I'm sure you will also feel that you share the same worry and you would like to find a good way out among ourselves. Thank you very much.
The Director General Sir Charles, who has been kind enough to help us to get the package as well as promote our activities also. We won't forget the help and the support extended by South Indian Film Chamber, especially by Mr. Ravi Puttanagara, who is the Secretary of South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce, as the Secretary of the FFI, who are always with us. Whenever I saw, sir, I want certain things to be done, don't worry, sir, I am with you, why do you bother? My support is there. So it's kind of support that's the strength for us. We are enjoying this confidence, and we are not only the release, but all the support extended by the press and the media, which is being supporting us for our activities. And of course, we are having more such activities in the coming months. So on behalf of Indo-Cine Appreciation Board, we thank all of you to come forward to be here in this function and making this function a grand success. Thank you, friends. Please enjoy the film. Thank you.